The American Cancer Society has a mission of funding researchers at the early stage in their career. It's during this time where it's very difficult to get grants from the national funding agencies because you have to have a great deal of preliminary data before they're willing to support that work. This is the microfluidic chip that I developed while I was funded under the American Cancer Society. And what this chip does is it isolates circulating tumor cells, or rare cells that are in the blood that circulate around when a person has cancer. And the way that the chip works is you simply have blood go into one port and then exit through the other port. The cancer cells stay behind, and all the unwanted cells like red blood cells and platelets go out. We can get the genetic fingerprint or the tumor type from the cells that are captured on the chip. We would like to come up with a liquid biopsy that would replace the surgical biopsy for a diagnosis of cancer. The idea would be that you would go to your doctor's office, you would have a simple blood draw, and then from that blood we would analyze it using our microfluidic device and identify any cancer cells that are circulating around in your blood. While I was getting my PhD in mechanical engineering, my stepmother was diagnosed with stage 3B breast cancer. It was something that was devastating to the whole family, and also seeing various extensive chemotherapies that were subscribed to her and then finding out that some of them weren't actually working and that her cancer grew during the time that she was on this medication. This motivated me when I was doing my postdoctoral research to switch my focus to cancer research. So one of my hopes with this circulating tumor cell chip is that when patients go through their treatment, they get answers quickly. They don't have to wait 6 to 8 weeks to find out the chemotherapy that they were on wasn't working. That those patients can live longer, happier lives, and celebrate as many birthdays as they can. When I participate in American Cancer Society events like Relay for Life and I see the Survivor's Lab, those are things that really motivate me to come back, work longer hours, harder in the lab, more weekends, because I really want to figure out a way that my son, that he thinks of cancer as something that is now manageable or hopefully a distant memory from things that people have to deal with. So when my friends ask me what can they do to help cancer research, or when I send out a request when I'm participating in a relay or a breast cancer walk, I say to them that, please come and join my team, walk with us, help fundraise. But for some people in these economic times, that can also be challenging. You don't always have spare money that you can donate, but volunteer at these events. So whatever you can do, whatever time that you can spare, it's greatly appreciated by researchers and all of the patients that are recipients of the great advances that we're able to make.